Like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. But for today's video, we're going to be talking about a post by Meddler, his quick gameplay thoughts for June 14th, in which case they mentioned crit ADCs in a section that reads, "We're working on buffing the performance of some ADCs in 8.13. That'll be focused on those who need some help like Triss, Vayne, or Jinx. We want to get a range of crit ADCs back into being reasonable choices, at least in regular play, quickly. We have no desire to leave that group of champions without a home anywhere on Summoner's Rift. We also want to try and maintain some of the new diversity we're seeing sometimes in bot lane too, though, so are trying not to swing too hard and go back to only seeing marksmen. In terms of what's getting played at present, it's not clear yet what is optimal. We're seeing a range of different things tried in pro play, for example, with a wide range of success and failure. Also seeing a lot of players' discussion around non-marksmen dominating bot, though in most MMRs, regional play rates of non-marksmen are extremely low. Still some exceptions, though. In terms of how we'll be buffing, the things we're planning on targeting first is the performance of those struggling champions in the 1-2 item spike range. Looks like we pulled the crit users back a bit too far in that period, leaving them too dependent on getting to 3+ items to contribute. Given their multiplicative power late game, we do believe champions using those builds should be weaker mid game, but not to the extent that they are right now. That also ties in with lane diversity. We think it is driven significantly by really early game power, so buffing the mid game should be compatible with putting both crit ADs back in a better spot and keeping some increased lane diversity for those who want it. Now, thanks to SpiderX, the literal god amongst men, who linked me this over on Twitter, there's also a post down in the comment section in which someone asked, "Crush on Jinx from Europe West, about Jinx. Maybe it's a good idea to scale the rocket launcher a bit with better AD or attack speed, or reducing the cooldown on her E, which is the flame chompers, from 24 to 10 seconds to 20 to 10 seconds. Any thoughts on that, Meddler?" In which case, Meddler mentioned, "What we'll first be testing for Jinx is 1, allowing the bonus rocket damage, the 10%, to also crit, and a higher AD ratio on W." So real quick, let me talk about these two things before I get into the video at large. Allowing the bonus rocket damage, the 10% to crit, for those that don't know, that don't play a lot of Jinx or play against a lot of Jinx even, in rocket form she gains 10% bonus AD, so if she had 70% attack damage, her rockets will be doing 77 attack damage, and allowing that to crit per se. When it comes to the higher ratio on the W, if you remember back in Season 7, if you were here, they tried to allow the W to crit actually, and it would be a certain color change when it would crit, so you'd know if you're playing against Jinx to dodge this one, because that specific color meant it was going to crit. You need to dodge that, that was painful. They obviously didn't go through with that, but making a higher AD ratio on W would be to the whole concept of spells on things like DPS AD carries, is spells, and those are supposed to be more powerful to get you through the early to mid game, so that late game you can switch over to your auto attacks and DPS. So things like Jinx's Zap does feel maybe quote-unquote useless later on in the game, because it's supposed to. It's supposed to fall off like most things, and you're supposed to be more of a DPS. You have the attack speed by that point, you have the attack power by that point, so you want to just use your auto attacks. But in the early game, things like Zap and stuff is supposed to be more powerful. So making a higher AD ratio on the W would allow not even just it to be more better in lane for poke and stuff, maybe even to max that first. Not necessarily that you should max that first, I'm just saying there are some people, Jinx players I know, that actually do like to max W first if it seems viable. So that might be also with that as well, so that you can actually just have a better trading tool in lane. So, in terms of the post in general, I know people are going to say, you know, AD carries whine, their role has been powerful for 5 years, and etc., etc., and I have to roll my eyes, honestly, because when it talks about viability, we're not talking about meta. We're just talking about being playable, right? You go back to the world's meta with the Ardent Censor. The problem wasn't that AD carries were all powerful and just unable to be touched on their own. It was the fact that their counters, like assassins, weren't powerful enough to be able to deal with immobile AD carries like they should be. That should have been the case. When those carries start being meta, you should be seeing the Zeds and stuff like that. And they weren't that powerful enough. They weren't not just not meta, but not viable. And that's what I want to really touch on. When we come back to the tank meta back in Season 6, the problem wasn't that tanks were just too powerful. Well, actually, yeah, it was. But the problem also was other classes in top lane were not viable. Not just not, you know, meta, not viable. A good example of this recently would be top lane when it comes to bruisers not feeling like they had a keystone. The problem wasn't that you couldn't play them or that they weren't meta, they weren't like the things you had to pick ban and stuff like that, is that they felt like they weren't playable at all. And that's the problem that's going on right here. Because a lot of people just want to chalk things up to people are whining, and people are whining about people are whining, and other people are whining about people whining. It's like, here's the thing. This specifically, what they're talking about, is the thing about viability. Not meta, viability. Right now, it feels like you should not play crit marksman literally ever. not because they're not the top tier stuff, because you should never play them actually ever. And so that's what they're going over right now. That's the kind of thing that's come up, that's being addressed, that's a problem that they're going to be talking about and stuff like that. And I just wanted to bring that up because a lot of people will go, you know, oh, this is AD carry mains, whining as usual. And to that point, let me also explain, other roles have had other classes of champion be viable and rotate in and out the meta. For, you know, crit AD carries and AD carries specifically, have a little patience because this is something that's kind of new, right? Bruiser's bot lane and stuff like that, that's new territory. It's not like other metas where it's like in mid lane, oh, mages are now meta, time to switch from assassins to mid lanes. Or top lane, okay, tanks are meta, time to switch from bruisers to tanks. AD carry has kind of always just been this. So have just a little bit of patience with the learning curve of having to play new champions bottom lane. Should it be a thing? Of course, I'm all for the, you know, the diversity and the viability of other champions bottom lane, but understand this isn't an addressing to, you know, oh, AD carry is even a little bit weak, time to buff them. It's more like, hey, let's make sure that they're viable too, so that if you are an assassin main, and even though mages are meta mid lane, you can still play assassins. Or if you're a fighter main, and you want to still play those top lane with takes are meta, you still can. Same concept, if you're an AD carry main, you still just want to play AD carries, like those other classes, just play assassins or just play fighters, you can in the bottom lane. So, that's all for this video. A little bit longer than I meant to it to be, but I really wanted to get that other stuff in the end explained to some people. I don't know if they quite understand that. So, thank you so much for watching this video. Feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. But, I don't know what to do next, because I can have a lot of kinks. So until next time, take care. GG, get jinxed. Thank you for watching. Enjoy pizza responsibly.